Hello guys, today I am going to introduce you two protocols, Go Back N protocol and Selective Repeat protocol. Actually, Go Back N protocol and Selective Repeat protocol are the two error control mechanisms used in sliding window protocol. And this sliding window protocol resides in the data link control layer of the network operating system. First, we will see the Go Back N protocol. To improve the efficiency of transmission, multiple frames must be outstanding while waiting for acknowledgement. In other words, we need to let more than one frame be outstanding to keep the channel busy while the sender is waiting for acknowledgement. Go Back N automatic repeat request protocol sends several frames before receiving acknowledgements. It keeps a copy of these frames until the acknowledgement arrives. Then sequence numbers used in Go Back N protocol. The frames from the sending station are numbered sequentially. However, because we need to include the sequence number of each frame in the header, we need to set a limit. If the header of the frame allows m bits for the sequence number, and if m is equal to 4, then the available sequence numbers are from 0 to 15, inclusive both. Here we are using modulo 2 arithmetic. That means after sequence number 0, 1, 2 up to 15, again this sequence is repeated. The send window is an imaginary box covering the sequence numbers of the data frames. And these data frames are in transit, that is outstanding. In each window position, some of these sequence numbers defines the frames that have been sent. Other defines those that can be sent. The maximum size of the window is 2^m-1. And figure shows sliding window of size 15, that is m is equal to 4. The window at any time divides the possible sequence numbers into four regions. The first region, that is from the far left to the left wall of the window. This region defines the sequence number belonging to the frames that are already acknowledged. The sender does not worry about these frames and keeps no copies of them. The second region, shown by the colored area within the figure, defines the range of sequence numbers belonging to the frames that are sent and have an unknown status. The sender needs to wait to find out if these frames have been received or were lost. We call these frames as a outstanding frames. The third range, shown by the white area in the figure, defines the range of sequence numbers for the frames that can be sent. However, the corresponding data packets have not yet been received from the network layer. Finally, fourth region defines sequence numbers that cannot be used until the window slides. Then figure B shows how the send window can slide one or more slots to the right when the acknowledgement arrives from the other end. The acknowledgements in this protocol are cumulative, meaning is that more than one frame can be acknowledged by the acknowledgement frame. In the figure, frames 0, 1, 2 are acknowledged, so the window has slid to the right three slots. The receive window makes sure that the correct data frames are received and that the correct acknowledgements are sent. The size of the receive window is always 1, which is shown in this figure. The receiver is always looking for the arrival of specific frame. Any frame arriving out of order is discarded and needs to be resent. The sequence numbers to the left of the window belongs to the frames already received and acknowledged. and the sequence numbers to the right of the window defines the frames that cannot be reissued. Any reissued frame with a sequence number in these two regions is discarded. Only the frame with a sequence number matching the value of variable RN is accepted and acknowledged. The reissue window also slides, but only one slot at a time. And this sliding happens when the correct frame is reissued by the receiver. And this figure shows the design of Go Back N ARQ protocol. First, we will see timers. Although there can be a timer for each frame that is sent, in this protocol, we use only one timer. The reason is that the timer for the first outstanding frame always expires first. We send all outstanding frames when this timer expires, then acknowledgement. The sender sends a positive acknowledgement if a frame has arrived safe and it is in order. If a frame is damaged or is reissued out of order, the receiver is silent. It doesn't reissue the frame, it discards that frame. Again, along with this frame, it discards all subsequent frames until it reissues the one it is expecting. The silence of the receiver causes the timer of the unacknowledgement. Then we'll see here acknowledgement. The receiver sends a positive acknowledgement if a frame has arrived safe and sound and in order. If a frame is damaged or is reissued out of order, the receiver is silent and will discard all subsequent frames until it reissues the one it is expecting. The silence of the receiver causes the timer of the unacknowledged frame at the sender side to expire. This in turn causes the sender to go back and resend all frames, beginning with the one with the expired timer. The receiver does not have to acknowledge each frame received. It can send only cumulative acknowledgement for several frames. Then resending of the frame. When the timer expires, the sender sends all outstanding frames. For example, suppose the sender has already sent frame 6, but the timer for frame 3 expires. This means that frame 3 has not been acknowledged. The sender goes back and sends frames 3, 4, 5, and 6 again. That is why the protocol is called Go Back N ARQ protocol. This figure shows the actual design. As we can see, multiple frames can be in transit in the forward direction and multiple acknowledgements in the reverse direction. This idea is similar to the stop and wait ARQ protocol. The difference is that the send window allows us to have many frames in the transition as there are slots in the same window. Then the send window size. In Go Back N ARQ protocol, the size of the send window must be less than 2^m. For example, if m is equal to 2, we will take it as a 2^m, that is 4 minus 1, that is 3. And the size of the receiver window is always 1. Then we will see the piggybacking concept used in Go Back N ARQ protocol. In this protocol, data frames are normally flowing in both directions. That is from node A to node B and from node B to node A. This means that the acknowledgements also need to flow in both directions. A technique called piggybacking is used to improve the efficiency of bidirectional protocols. When a frame is carrying data from A to B, it can also carry acknowledgement about the arrived frames from B. When frame is carrying data from B to A, it can also carry acknowledgements about the arrived frames from the A. We show the design for go back n using piggybacking in the figure. Note that each node now has a two windows, one send window and one receive window. Both also need to use a timer. Both are involved in three types of events: request, arrival, and timeout event. However, the arrival event here is complicated. When a frame arrives, the site needs to handle acknowledgements as well as the frame itself. Both of these concerns must be taken care of in one event, that is in arrival event. The request event uses only the send window at each site. The arrival event needs to use both windows. Then we'll see selective repeat protocol. Go back n ARQ simplifies the process at the receiver side. The receiver keeps the track of only one variable, and there is no need to buffer out of order frames. They are simply discarded. However, in selective repeat protocol, things are somewhat different. In previous protocol, the actual out of order frames are discarded and not stored, and this protocol is very inefficient for noisy link. In noisy link, a frames has a higher probability of damage. Under such situations, we have to use somewhat another mechanism which is suitable for noisy links. And this mechanism is called as a selective repeat ARQ, which is more efficient for noisy links. But the processing at the receiver is more complex. Selective repeat protocol also uses two windows, a send window and the receive window. However, there are differences between the windows in this protocol and the ones windows used in previous protocol, that is go back n protocol. First, the size of the window is much smaller. That is 2^m-1. For example, here 2^m is equal to, suppose 2, that is 2^m-1. Here m is 2 minus 1 is 1, that is 2^1 is the window size is 2. Then you can take example here. 4. Now we will see selective repeat automatic repeat request protocol. Now we will see selective repeat protocol. Go back n ARQ simplifies the process at the receiver side. The receiver keeps track of only one variable, and there is no need to buffer out of order frames. Now we will see selective repeat protocol. In go back n ARQ protocol, the process at the receiver side is simple. The receiver keeps the track of only one variable, and there is no need to buffer out of order frames. They are simply discarded. However, this protocol is very inefficient for the noisy link. In a noisy link, a frame has a higher probability of damage. The mechanism called selective repeat ARQ is more efficient for noisy links, but the processing at the receiver is more complex. The selective repeat protocol also uses two windows, a send window and receive window. However, there are differences between the windows in this protocol and the windows used in previous protocol, that is go back n protocol. The first is the size of send window. Here the size of send window is much smaller, that is 2^m-1. For example, here take m is equal to 4. Here m minus 1 is 3. So 2 raised to 3 is window size becomes 8. If it is compared with window size in go back n protocol, in go back n protocol, window size is 2 raised to m, that is 2 raised to 4, that is 16, and 16 minus 1 is equal to 15. So as compared to the go back n protocol, window size is less in the selective repeat protocol. The receive window in selective repeat protocol is totally different from the window used in go back n concept. First, the size of the receive window is the same as the size of the send window. The selective repeat protocol allows as many frames as the size of receive window to arrive out of order and keep until there is a set of in order frames to be delivered to the network layer. Because of the sizes of the send window and the receive window are same, all the frames in the now we will see selective repeat ARQ protocol. Go back n ARQ simplifies the process at the receiver side. The receiver keeps track of only one variable, and there is no need to buffer out of order frames. They are simply discarded. However, this protocol is very inefficient for noisy link. In a noisy link, a frame has a higher probability of damage. The mechanism called selective repeat ARQ is more efficient for noisy links, but the processing at the receiver is more complex. The selective repeat protocol also uses two windows, a send window and a receive window. However, there are differences between the windows in this protocol and the windows used in the previous protocol, that is in go back n protocol. The size of the window is much smaller in this case. The send window maximum size can be 2 raised to m minus 1. For example, if m is equal to 4, the sequence numbers goes from 0 to 15. But the size of window is just 8. And it is 15 in go back n protocol. The window in selective repeat is totally different from the one in go back n protocol. First, the size of the receive window is small as the size of the send window. The selective repeat protocol allows as many frames as the size of the selective window. Now, we will see selective repeat protocol. Go back n, ARQ simplifies the process at the receiver side. The receiver keeps the track of only one variable, and there is no need to buffer out of order frames. Now, we will see selective repeat automatic repeat request protocol. Go back n, ARQ simplifies the process at the receiver side. The receiver keeps the track of only one variable, and there is no need to buffer out of order frames. They are simply discarded. However, this protocol is very inefficient for a noisy link. In a noisy link, a frame has a higher probability of damage. The mechanism called selective repeat ARQ is more efficient for noisy links, but the processing at the receiver is more complex. The selective repeat protocol also uses two windows, a send window and the receive window. However, there are differences between the windows in this protocol and windows used in previous protocol, that is go back n protocol. The size of window is much smaller, that is 2 raised to m minus 1. The send window maximum size is 2 raised to m minus 1. For example, if m is equal to 4, the sequence numbers starts from 0 and ends to 15. But the size of window is just 8. And this size is 15 in case of go back n protocol. The receive window in a selective repeat is totally different from the one in go back n protocol. First, the size of the receive window is the same as the size of send window, that is 2^m-1. The selective repeat protocol allows the many frames as the size of receive window. It allows the window size number of frames to arrive out of order and be kept until there is a set of in order frames to be delivered to the network layer. Because the size of the window, send window and the receive window are the same, all the frames in the same frame can arrive out of order and be stored until they can be delivered. We need, however, to mention that the receiver never delivers packets out of order to the network layer. Figure shows the receive window. Those slots inside the window that are colored defines frames that have arrived out of order and are waiting for their neighbors to arrive before delivery to network layer. The design of the selective repeat ARQ protocol is shown in this figure. The design in this case is to some extent similar to the design of the go back N, but this design is more complicated. The size of window, sender window, must be equal to the size of receive window. And in the size of the sender and receiver window must be at the most 1/2 of 2^m. Finally, I will summarize the operation of selective repeat ARQ protocol. In selective repeat ARQ protocol, at a time, there are outstanding frame, number of frames, outstanding frame is equal to the window size at the transmitter. That means, without expecting the acknowledgement, transmitter sends the number of frames is equal to window size. Then in receiver, the frames are received and stored in the buffers. And if receiver observes the error in a particular frame, only negative acknowledgement related to that frame is transmitted to the sender. And transmitter resends only error frame. All another frames are maintained within the buffers of the receiver, and when error frame is get retransmitted by the transmitter and reaches to the receiver, receiver receives that frame and makes executes the recycling mechanisms, and all frames are put in order and then forwarded to the network layer. So this is about selective repeat ARQ protocol. Thank you.